my name is Jalen Hinton, class of 2019, and I'm standing here with Malcolm Gibson, class of 87. And what I want to ask you today is, what does it mean to you to be a Purple Knight?
I could probably talk about that for hours, but a Purple Knight means to me is being, first, a good man, a God-fearing man, and a dedicated man. Probably go off script. I mean, St. Augustine has been so much to me. All of my sons have gone there. I've not left there, even though this is homecoming. I'm here, but I'm just proud to see where we've come from, you know, since I was there in eighth grade in 1982. That's when I got there. But I've gone from Atlanta to D.C. to all parts of the country, and you never know, Purple Knights are all over. And when you put that little thing on your resume, graduated from St. Augustine, you'll be surprised what kind of doors will open up for you.
Yes, sir. So as a St. Augustine High School graduate and as a proud graduate of St. Augustine High School, what are some ways that you give back to the St. Augustine High School community and school?
First of all, tuition. I sent three of my boys there. Right now, my nephew is there. Secondly, you'd be surprised the number of calls we get for kids that need assistance. So myself and my business, Professional Funeral Services, always contributes when the phone rings. Without question, they know that they can call and we will dedicate ourselves and put our money where our mouth is.
So you're part of a long line of St. Augustine High School men who are successful in the community as businessmen and as civic leaders. So how has St. Augustine High School prepared you to go into your field of business?
No excuses, excellence, determination. Expect that you have to work three times as hard to get recognized. It's just a normal for us, that's not an exception. That's what we expect. But also, we also recognize when we do get to that place, we have an obligation and a duty to give back, to open the doors for young men like yourself. So whatever field that you want to go in, I assure you there's a St. Augustine graduate that's there and more than willing to open the door for you. And we do the same thing.
And I'm standing here with Mr. Lewis Salord, class of 76. And you're up for a service award today. So can you tell me what it's like to graduate from St. Aug, become involved with the school as a basketball coach, and many years later to come back and receive an award?
I love it. It's great to be acknowledged. You know, it's been a lot of years, but it was all fun. Proud to be associated with the school, man. It means a lot to me.
So working as a basketball coach at St. Aug, you were obviously involved in many of these young men's lives. So do you believe as an educator, as a coach, that there was more value having an impact on these young men's lives compared to earning a big paycheck?
Yeah, well, that's the way I'm living. Best thing I think I could do for them is set that example, to live that way. And that's what I do, and I have fun doing it, and I hope they pick up on it.
And my last question for you is, graduated from St. Aug, what are some ways that you have given back once you retire from being a coach?
Man, just trying to show each kid how important I think he is. Help the parents experience the great benefit of making the sacrifice to send their kids to the school. Make sure, as I said before, set that example for them. And hopefully those kids, after they get on, do their thing, they can come back and do the same thing for some other kids.
And just one more question, if you may. So as a graduate of St. Aug, you've been through it all. What is one thing you would tell someone who is a current student at St. Aug? What would you tell them to do at St. Aug, their experience and everything?
Just remember, as many of the guys you're in school with, and as many of the teachers that help you to grow. You know, networking is a popular, important thing. And the guys you meet in high school, you'll know them, you'll remember them for the rest of your lives, you know. And it's just great to be a part of the St. Augustine tradition in that way.
And I'm standing here with Mr. Freddie Jones, class of 96. And my first question for you today is, what are some ways you have given back to the St. Augustine High School community once you walked the stage and left?
One of the many ways that we've given back is I always come back to the school and try to talk to the students as much as I can. I'm actually about to finish up a 20-year stint in the United States Air Force. So with that being said, every time I do come back, I try to talk to the kids about not just joining the military, but being productive in the community. You can pay it forward in many ways. Coming back to the school, supporting the bookstore, supporting the alumni council, and federation, and things of that nature.
So you just mentioned that you served in the Air Force for 20 years.
Yeah.
So being in the military, you were a civic leader. You were a leader in your community. So what ways have St. Augustine High School prepared you to be a leader in your community?
That's easy. It provided a mentorship, leadership, and compassion for your fellow brothers and sisters and whatnot. I will say this, throughout my 4 years at St. Augustine, I've learned so much how to become a young man into the manifestation of becoming a man and whatnot. And it's certainly helped me throughout my career, and I'm grateful for it.
Yes, sir. And what you just said were St. Augustine High School has prepared you for a leader. They instilled a lot of values in you. So what would you tell to a student who's in the 8th grade, he's graduating, and he's considering to attend a school like Holy Cross, a Jesuit? Why would he choose St. Augustine High School over those schools?
Those are good schools, but if you want to be great, go to a great school. You'll never find another patronage like students from St. Augustine. I mean, granted, here I am 20 years later coming back, and I love this school, love walking through the hallways, and also the camaraderie. It's almost like, you know, a military, it's a brotherhood, exactly what they say it is. Yes, when you have your graduating class, those are your brothers now. Those are guys that you will network with for the rest of your life and whatnot. We network with brothers from years past and years into the future and whatnot. So that's what I was saying, you know, please do support your schools. Please do support St. Augustine High.
So one thing you just mentioned was camaraderie and brotherhood in the St. Augustine High School community. So what would you say to someone if they said something like, oh, Jesuit has a brotherhood, or Holy Cross has a brotherhood, or John Curtis? What makes St. Augustine High School unique as a brotherhood compared to other schools?
Great question. What St. Augustine brings to the table is, it takes you from boyhood, like I said earlier, to manhood, young manhood, and then to manhood. Everyone, yes, we do have a brotherhood, but there's nothing like that purple and gold brotherhood that I've seen anywhere else. Even in the military, there's that brotherhood that I see here. It's almost compared to what I see in the military, and when I if almost close. St. Augustine is St. Augustine. I mean, it's all for the reason.
All right, thank you for the interview. My name is Jalen Hinton. We're signing off.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, no worries.
And I'm standing here, and I'm going to let him introduce himself.
My name is Ed Shanklin, class of 76.
So, Mr. Ed Shanklin, you told me that you are an investment banker.
Yes.
You know, you work in the banking industry. Work on Wall Street. So, working on Wall Street, that means you're a leader in your community,
yes,
in your business. So obviously you have a foundation. So you graduated from St. Aug.
That's correct.
So my question is, how has St. Aug laid a foundation in you to be a leader?
St. Aug provided the foundation for me to be the leader. Working in as a student, seeing Mr. Flint, Coach Washington, and all of Mr. Scott, all of the leaders and teachers that was around me as a mentor, Mr. Anthony Simmons, was someone that guided me to my profession. So that's what St. Aug did for me.
So I'm working on Wall Street. Have you had experience with any St. Aug Purple Knights on Wall Street?
No, I have not. I have not run into any other Purple Knights almost. Well, no, I do. I'm sorry. Howard Rogers. I don't know his class, but yes, I do. I ran into Howard Rogers. He and I work closely together.
One thing, when I talk to Purple Knights who are professionals, one thing that they tell me is that being a Purple Knight has helped them in their application process. When they see that name, St. Augustine High School, that helps them out. So can you tell me an experience where the St. Augustine High School title has helped you out in your career?
Whenever I introduce myself professionally as a St. Augustine graduate. That's the first thing I do. I'm a St. Augustine graduate first, and then I talk about the college. So that's what St. Aug has done for me. That's what I do.
Yes, sir. And what I want to state is that what you said about you introducing your high school, St. Augustine High School, that just shows the foundation that it lays in you, that you have pride in your school and the community that you come from. So I just wanted to say it's really special that you said that.
Yes.
So thank you for the interview, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I'm standing here with Derek Warren, class of 1986, the self-titled GQ class, like you said earlier. So you take a lot of pride in that, being a quote-unquote GQ class. So can you tell me the pride that you have in your class, being SNO?
The tradition that's passed on of the institution, and speaking of all the core values of the young men that came through St. Augustine, not only academics, athletic, but also being well-dressed and groomed. So class of 86 being the last class to wear regular clothes before you all went into uniform makes it a little special because of the fact that we, you know, had some pretty decked out guys, you know, dressing up. So we take pride in that.
Yes, sir. So one thing that I noticed that when you were up there taking your picture with your class, all you guys were laughing, you were joking. It felt like y'all seeing each other like every single day. So can you tell me, how do you all keep in contact with each other? I know some of y'all moved away from the city and everything.
It's just St. Augustine has a tradition, a family. It's like, you know, I don't care if you graduated in 51, 86, 71, 72, we can leave each other for several years, but when we come back, it's like we never skip a beat. It's like we just missed the day of high school and we right back waiting on the next day. So we keep that bond, we keep in touch by calling each other, by still visiting each other, and that goes not only with our class, but just St. Augustine graduates in general.
One point I want to say is that I was at the St. Aug alumni golf tournament earlier, and I was golfing with some St. Aug grads from one of the earlier classes, and some of them haven't seen each other in like 25 years, and when they were talking, it was like they never skipped a beat, like you said. So that's just something that is unique about our school. You know, I'm class of 2019, and I look forward to one day being, you know, just a little older, but still being one of the guys and talking and never skipping a beat. So thank you for the interview, sir.
All right, thank you, sir. All right. Two corporate night.
Thank
God
you.
God bless.
Thank you. And I'm standing here with Kevin Montgomery, class of 86. And what I want to ask you is that you're an engineer with NASA. I'm assuming it took you a lot of time to get there to be an engineer at a premier institution like NASA. So how has St. Aug prepared you to get to that level?
Just basically discipline, good study habits, but mostly discipline. Engineering takes a lot of discipline, a lot of math involved, science, technology, but the application of the experience of just learning, understanding. I mean, we mentioned Carl Bluen tonight, very instrumental in my development as a young student. I must attest to, if it wasn't for him, then I probably wouldn't be an engineer. You know, I learned math and trigonometry through him, and it really helped me advance throughout college, throughout, of course, my continuing studies at St. Augustine, and through my profession.
So one question is that one thing that I talk to a lot of St. Aug alumni who are professionals, they tell me that that St. Aug title in their application has taken them a long way. So can you tell me a story of your title as a St. Aug Purple Knight helping you in your career and your profession?
It's just a networking. It's just insurmountable what you can accomplish by just saying that, you know, you're an actual alumnus of St. Augustine. Everybody in this city, in this state, a lot of people in this country understands and knows what it takes to be a graduate of St. Augustine. And by us exhibiting that pride, just throughout, is very, very helpful. And the value just that we derive from that, of course, it's just unparalleled to anything else.
So we are part of a unique community. It's called St. Augustine High School. I mean, we're the only school in America that is an all-black, all-male Catholic school that continues to produce leaders in the community. So my question for you is, how do you give back to this community so that future generations can have the same success as you did?
Mentoring, leading by example are the two most important things to me. You know, I wish I had the opportunity to spend more time with my fellow Purple Knights. Unfortunately, I live out of town, but we do some things through the alumni chapter in Houston. So we're going to work on establishing more of the channel or of connecting with our young St. Augustine students so that we can give back more in the future.
23, and what I want to ask you is that when you were being presented for your award, they said that you give back to the school and events. So what does it mean to be a Purple Knight and be able to give back to the community that did so much for you?
Look, this means a lot to me because this award, this is the Lawrence T. Winchester Award. Mr. Winchester, I met him in my freshman year at St. Aug, and he was my teacher, and I was also the Marching 100 in the band, and I had him twice. And Mr. Winchester was a great, in my life, I mean, just a great mentor. And between Mr. Winchester, Blue, and Hampton, that was the most strenuous, and I would like to say, difficult thing I had to do in life, but that's what made me what I am today. By these guys and stuff like that, being taught by these guys, and I'm proud to get this award from Mr. Winchester, who was my friend. Not only after I finished from St. Aug, Winchester and I, we kept in contact even after the storm. He moved to Atlanta, Georgia, and him and I would talk every day, or not every day, almost on a weekly basis, and we respected each other, and we kept in contact to the day Mr. Winchester passed almost. And I am so honored and pleased to get this award, the Lawrence T. Winchester Award, and I'm a proud and glad Purple Knight.
Sir, so one thing I just say is pride. So I can tell that you're a very proud man. You said you're a part of Marching 100, St. Aug graduate. So one thing I want to ask you is, having that pride, how has that helped you in your life?
Well, put it like this. It helped me because it teaches you lessons in life. As a matter of fact, I work for right now a company called Chisasi Meat Company. I started at Chisasi as the first black sales rep, and now I'm sales manager over there. And I take in pride in all this teaching come from back to St. Aug that I can teach other people now what I've learned, what I've known, and that's why I'm topping sales and have my sales force topping sales at the company where I am, thanks to St. Augustine.
So you said that you were the first black sales rep, and now that you've been promoted to sales manager. So how has St. Aug helped you to endure through rising up through the corporate ladders?
Well, I tell you what, I was taught at St. Aug always, no one's going to give you nothing. And that was Mr. Bluen. No one's going to give you anything. You have to earn it. And damn it, you earned it over there from these people. And that was the hard part. On my job at Chisasi, this is the easy part. This is easy because the hardest times in my life were at St. Augustine. And I appreciate the teachings and things like Mr. Willett and stuff like that. Always excellence. When you walked into the building in the morning, there was Mr. Willett clapping. Excellence, excellence. And he taught you to be the best at whatever you were going to do, and that still stick with me today.
19, I'm standing here with Mr. Willard, graduate of class of 82. And Mr. Willard, I want to say that you are a distinguished leader within your community. You are risen through the justice system as a judge. And I want to ask you, as a St. Aug Purple Knight, how has that prepared you to become a successful lawyer and judge?
Thank you, Mr. Hinton. It all started probably in 1977, 78, thereabout, when I started the summer program in order to enter eighth grade at St. Augustine. I had come from a background of Josephites at St. Raymond Elementary School, and discipline was probably the foundation which led us in the direction, when I say us, most Purple Knights, if not all Purple Knights, in the direction of making a difference in the communities that we serve. 1977 it all started, and I graduated in 1982. But during that particular 5-year period, it was definitely a life-changing experience. I met a lot of great friends that I'm still in touch with today. In fact, a couple of them are employed with me at criminal court in my judgeship. I've got a couple Purple Knights that serve with me as colleagues as judge at Tulane and Broad, which is where criminal court is. And we also have a number of judges at civil district court. So the St. Augustine family has really been productive in terms of putting out outstanding young men like yourself and like Mr. Mark Paul, who's back here, and the big shoes I'm following, talking about Brother Calvin Charbonnet, CJ, whom was interviewed right before me. We've got a lot of big shoes to fill by succeeding individuals like that. But the foundation which taught us all, I believe, was the discipline that we received, the camaraderie received among students, the support you got from faculty and staff, and just the love and care, which is what you received from the community. St. Augustine really back in the day was a community school, and I think today it still serves as such. And I'm proud that people like yourself will be graduating in a couple years.
Yeah, 2019.
We look forward to seeing great things from you. Now, as I mentioned earlier, the trailblazers have been there, like Brother Charbonnet, and whom I mentioned earlier, an individual who's very instrumental in my education, Mr. Carl Bluen, who graduated in the first graduating class from St. Augustine, I believe, in 1954, and he came back right after Xavier, which is my alma mater as well, and he taught at St. Augustine since the 50s up until his recent retirement, and then he still came back in different capacities, all during that time, serving in the band, as a band director, served as principal, served as a mentor and a tutor. And those are the kinds of individuals we met. That's the kind of dedication that St. Augustine Purple Knights have. And the great thing about the institution is, honestly, you can go to any city within Louisiana, no matter how big or small, you're gonna find somebody who graduated from St. Augustine, or at least somebody who's familiar with the Purple Knights. You go to any 50 of our 50 states, and I'm also a military officer and been to a lot of different military bases. You will find someone within all 50 states familiar with St. Augustine or who graduated from there. And the reason I bring that up is because a few years ago, I was on military assignment in Germany, and I had on a shirt that said, "I am St. Aug," and a guy walks up to me, and lo and behold, he's a 1985 graduate from the Lower Ninth Ward. But he and I talked in Stuttgart, Germany, about our days at St. Augustine. So I want to thank you guys for what it is you do. I want to thank the school for what it has done for people like myself. And I look forward to the great things that you can do and will do in the future.
And I want to personally thank you because your son, Jonathan Willard, I know that he attends Howard University. And he's been mentoring me about going to Howard. And I know he wants to go into the sports industry, and that's what I want to do. So he's really been helping me out. So you and your entire Willard family has really exemplified what it means to be a Purple Knight. So I want to thank you for that.
I appreciate it. Howard's a good choice for you. He's up there doing well and doing some good things. But his brother's at Tuskegee, and they have a very fine program as well.
Yes, sir. So you just said that Jonathan, he was a salutatorian, and you had another son who was a valedictorian class of 2014.
Joshua.
Yes, who is currently at Tuskegee. So as a parent, this goes beyond saying, what is the blueprint and foundation for your children's success?
Again, it was easy for me because my dad was such a trailblazer when it came to education. He actually served at St. Augustine, and I don't know if you knew this, but he was the principal there when I was a young kid from 1969 to 1974. And he went on to become a principal at another school. But in terms of education, the blueprint was already laid for myself and my wife. And she came from a very positive family where education was also important. So it was easy for us. And we were just thankful that our sons took to it, did well, and stayed the course.
My last question for you is that you're a very proud St. Aug Purple Knight. So what would you tell someone who is graduated from the 8th grade, who's considering many different schools, such as Rummel, or Holy Cross, or Jesuit, one of these schools, what would you tell them about St. Aug that makes us unique, and why they should come here?
I will probably get myself in trouble as an elected judge, but I'll say this. On the news today, it was broadcast. A young lady who's a freshman, maybe a sophomore at LSU, received a very nasty message about her color and her kind not being welcomed at that particular institution. To any of the young men who want to find themselves and stay with family, because family is all we have at the end of the day, you will always feel at home if you walk through the halls at 2600, which is now AP Turo, 2600 London Avenue. And that just does not mean in the African American community. We are ready to embrace our Latino brothers. We are ready to embrace our European brothers, anybody, our Native American brothers. If they want to come and join the St. Augustine family, they are more than welcome. And we look forward to that. So I always say to those young guys who are really looking to find home and find family, it's no closer than 2600 AP Turo Avenue.
Good evening, and on behalf of the Josephite Society of St. Joseph Society of the Sacred Heart, we welcome you to this wonderful homecoming gala. And on behalf of the Josephite Administration, we congratulate all those who are celebrating their anniversaries. Give yourselves a round of applause this year, amen? And so, as we do, as we continue to do with everything at St. Augustine High School, we begin everything with prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Good and gracious God, we give you thanks for this opportunity of being once again in your presence and to celebrate the wonderful anniversaries of so many of our alumni. We ask that you continue to strengthen us with the spirit of St. Augustine in our hearts, that our hearts continue are restless until they find rest with you. We ask you, Almighty God, in a very special way for all our departed alumni that you have called home to be with you in glory. May they continue to celebrate the wonderful being sons of the golden purple in your presence. And tonight we thank you for all those who will be receiving awards. May they continue to shine your light of Christ's presence here on this earth. In all things, Almighty God, we give you the honor, the glory, and the praise. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Augustine.
Pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
My name is Kendrick Johnson, and I serve as the Director of Alumni Relations for St. Augustine High School. Every year we have a daunting task to find Purple Knights and other individuals who serve St. Augustine High School. We have a tough time finding and identifying those individuals to give them the honor that they deserve for their service. This year was unlike any other year. Our first recipient is a 1989 graduate of St. Augustine High School and has been an active member of the St. Augustine's Atlanta Alumni Chapter for over 15 years and currently serves as president. He has served as vice president and manages the silent auction that is associated with the Atlanta chapter's Mardi Gras ball. This Purple Knight has been instrumental in the advancement of St. Augustine High School. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me in congratulating the 2016 Lawrence T. Winchester Distinguished Award winner, Mr. Carl Bluen Jr., and accepting in his absence will be his father, Carl Bluen Sr., class of 1955. Our next recipient is a 1994 graduate of St. Augustine High School. He has served as an assistant football coach over 10 years and has volunteered countless hours. This Purple Knight has played a key role in the recruitment of student athletes due to his connections to the New Orleans Recreation Department. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating 2016 Lawrence T. Winchester Distinguished Award winner, Kareem Jefferson Sr. Our next recipient is a 1987 graduate of St. Augustine High School. And by the way, the class of 1987 are back-to-back Give Purple Day champions.
All right.
He has served as teacher, coach, and mentor for several years. In addition, he has created partnerships between St. Aug and the community, one of which feeds over 1,000 people during the Thanksgiving holidays. This Purple Knight has no limits when it comes to supporting St. Augustine's initiatives. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me in congratulating 2016 Lawrence T. Winchester Award winner, Malcolm Gibson. Our next recipient is a 1973 graduate of St. Augustine High School. He has volunteered for over 35 years and has served on the Alumni Advisory Board, the Cornerstone Club, and the Quarterback Club. He also served as the chairman of the annual Crawfish Boil for 10 years. This Purple Knight has donated food to various St. Aug events throughout the years. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me in congratulating 2016 Lawrence T. Winchester Distinguished Award winner, Calvin C.J. Charbonnet. Our next recipient is a 1976 graduate of St. Augustine High School. He is a consistent fixture within the St. Aug basketball program. He has served as an assistant coach on the varsity team and the head coach of the freshman team during the tenure of the last three head basketball coaches. In addition, he tutors student athletes and academics when needed. This Purple Knight also acts as a special consultant to the current coaching staff. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me in congratulating 2016 Lawrence T. Winchester Distinguished Award winner, Louis Soloy. Now this final award goes to a 1982 graduate of St. Augustine High School. He is a judge for the Orleans Parish Criminal Court, Section C in Orleans Parish. He was first elected on November 5th, 2002, and was re-elected without opposition in 2008. He was re-elected in 2014 for a term beginning on January 1st, 2015 and expiring on December 31st, 2020. He earned his JD from Southern University Law Center in 1992. Later, he worked as an adjunct faculty at Southern University. He is a consistent supporter of St. Augustine High School through mentoring, monetary donations, and volunteerism. He chaperones the March of 100 during carnival season, although he does not have a child participating in the band. This Purple Knight has faithfully served his alma mater and community for over 20 years. This award is not just a service award. This is the Father Charles Hall Alumnus of the Year Award, and it goes to Judge Benedict Willard.
Can we all stand, the Brothers of St. Augustine, and give Mr. Carl Bluen, who educated many, many, many persons within this particular room. I wouldn't be a judge today had I not gotten the lessons from his class and the way he taught us. So I stand here holding the Carl Hall Award. Never had the privilege of being taught by Carl Hall, but I was in Mr. Bluen's class for 3 years. Yes, because I was in A-track, you guys. Mr. Bluen, thank you for all that you've done for St. Augustine since 1951, correct, sir? And he continues to do it, so thank you for that. Brothers, thank you all for this award, and I appreciate it. Final award tonight is the Father Wilbur J. Atwood Lifetime Achievement Award. Father Howard Bird has served at St. Augustine High School for over 40 years. 40 years, wow. Whenever I talk to an alum, when I'm out visiting, they ask about three things. They ask about the Marching 100, they ask about the football team, and they ask about Father Bird. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please help me and welcome me the 2016 Father Wilbur J. Atwood Lifetime Achievement Award winner, Father Howard Bird. Thank you.
I always tell people I have three families. My biological family, my Josephite family, and my St. Augustine's family. Indeed, it has been a pleasure to be at St. Aug's for 40 years. I remember one time they had asked me about taking another job in our community. And they gave me some time to think about it. And I didn't want to take the job because I didn't want to leave St. Augustine. And at the time, I felt that was a little bit selfish on my part. But throughout the years that I've been there, I have met many people that I will say they are my friends for life. And truly, it is a blessing that I have been able to serve at St. Augustine's High School for these 40-some years. I would just say thank you and God bless you.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening. I'm Lloyd Craddock, president of St. Augustine High School and class of 76, celebrating 40 years. I get to close the program. As I think all of you know, I'm exiting the role as president in, I guess, about 30 days. And I wanted to just say that I'm extremely grateful to all of you here who were very helpful and supportive to me. And right at the top of that list for support is my my wife of 36 years, Annette Craddock right here, who over the last 3 years of this term, there were many days she didn't see me. So thank you, Annette. I love you for all the support. Alumni brothers and members of the St. Aug family, we made history this week, huge history. We had a St. Augustine Purple Knight, who's chairman of our board, announce to the community that a new president will be assuming leadership December 1st. So the chairman, who's a Purple Knight, announced that a Purple Knight will become the new president, succeeding a Purple Knight who was president. That's what we had happen this week, everyone. Doctors Kenneth St. Charles will assume the presidency. He's from the class of 81, and he's not here, but he's celebrating 35 years. I and Chairman Justin Augustine are celebrating 40 years. So somehow it was meant to be this way. When capable, high-performing Purple Knights work together, it's limitless what we can get done. And that's what's happening as we transition leadership for our school. So it's a great time. I said in an article after I announced my retirement that we're only raising the bar. And that's what's happening right now. We are raising the bar. And seeing Benedict get the award tonight just reminds me that the last time we had a doctor as president was Dr. Elliot C. Willard. And we always say that with great pride, Dr. Willard. So we will have Dr. St. Charles as the president leading St. Augustine. So I want all of you who were very supportive and helpful to me in leading our school to be equally, if not more so, supportive to Kenneth as he leads us. So thank you very much, and let's have a great night tonight. Rise, sons of the Golden Purple.
Thank you so much, all. I'm Warren Johnson, class of 81, and we're here to have some fun. I'm gonna acknowledge everyone that is celebrating a reunion. To be fair, we're gonna do this in chronological order. As I say to class, please stand, raise your hand, whoop and holler, do whatever you wanna do. Okay. Class of 1981. Woo! Okay, now we can continue.
Yeah.
class of 1956. Anybody here? There's one survivor. Let's say that again. 1956. Class of 1961. Anybody going once? There you go. That's a sympathy year. Class of 1966.
CJ?
Class of 1971. Yo! There you go. Class of 1976. All right, hold your ears. Class of 1981. Should I drop the mic? Class of 1986.
Bestowed upon us all this evening. Continue to strengthen our school, strengthen our alumni, and grant eternal rest and peace to those who have gone on before us, all our faculty, our staff, and of course, the Josephite priests and brothers who gave their lives for this institution. We grant all things through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Saint Joseph, Saint Augustine, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. And this time, I invite everyone to stand as we will sing our alma mater, please. And if you got your rings, you know what to do with them. Fill them up. Mm-hmm.
Bring it to a jeweler.
Together, one, two, three. My sons of the golden purple.